In this video, we're going to start the naming angles worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. This is a free worksheet and you can find it within the geometry section. Our directions for the first four problems are to name the vertex and sides of each angle. If you remember from my tutorial video, and I'll leave a link for that in the description below as well, an angle is formed by two rays extending from the same endpoint. And that endpoint that they extend from is known as the vertex. So you can see that in number one, we have ray MN. And when you label a ray, remember you're starting with the endpoint and then writing the next point where the line continues out of. So using that same format, we're going to say ML is the other ray, starting at the endpoint and then continuing past that L. And then again, an angle is formed by two rays that extend from the same endpoint, and that endpoint is known as the vertex, so the vertex is M. So we have our vertex, ray, and another ray. Continuing on to number two, we're looking for the endpoint of the two rays that intersect, and we know that is our vertex, so our vertex is D. Next, let's label our rays. Starting at the endpoint and going out, we have DE, so ray DE, and we also have ray DC. You go from the endpoint to the next point and draw an arrow above to represent the ray. Vertex D, ray DE, and then ray DC. For number three, our vertex is R. So we have vertex R. We'll have ray RS, and we'll also have ray RQ. And finally, number four. Our vertex in number four is T. We have ray T to S, so ray TS, and we also have ray TU. So you can see that an angle is made up of two rays that connect at the same endpoint, and that endpoint is the vertex. In number five through eight, so the next four problems, we're going to name each angle in four ways. When naming an angle, you can name it by the vertex as long as there is no other angle connected in. So we can call this angle, angle D, where this symbol represents angle, so this means angle D. We could also name an angle by the number associated with that angle. So this can also be called angle 3. And lastly, we can write an angle using one point, the vertex, and the third point. So we can say angle CDE, where the vertex is in the middle, but the vertex can be in the middle as well if we were to say EDC. So you use one point of one ray, the vertex of the angle, and then a point along the other ray, and vice versa. CDE or angle EDC. And don't forget your symbol for angle in front of each of those. Number six, let's start with the vertex again. F is our vertex, so let's name this angle F. 4 is the number associated with this angle, so we can also say angle 4. And then angle G, F to E, one point of one ray, the vertex, then the point of the other ray, angle G, F, E, and then we'll reorder that to be angle E, F, G. Angle F, angle 4, angle GFE, and angle EFG. Any of these names represent this angle. In number 7, our vertex is F, so we have angle F. The number is 1, so angle 1. And notice that that 1 is written within the angle itself, so the number will not be somewhere out here, it will always be within the angle. So angle 1, and then a point of one ray, vertex, point of the other ray. So let's say angle G, F, E, and then point of one ray, vertex, point of the other ray, angle, E, F, G. Four different ways to name the same angle. And number 8, our vertex is I, so we can name the angle in angle 8, angle I. The number associated with this angle is 3, so we can also call this angle 3. Then let's say JIH, so angle JIH, and then angle HIJ, where the vertex is always in the middle. And for the next four problems, numbers 9 through 12, we're going to draw and label an angle to fit each description. So number 9 says, an obtuse angle, angle Y. So we're going to draw an obtuse angle, which we know an obtuse angle is an angle that's greater than 90 degrees. And our label is Y. So we're going to write the vertex directly outside of the angle next to the endpoint where those two rays meet, Y. Moving on to number 10, it says an acute angle, JIH. So an acute angle is less than 90 degrees, and our label is JIH. Remember, the vertex is in the middle, so our vertex is I, and one point of one ray will be J, and a point on the other ray will be H. Angle JIH. And number 11, we have a right angle, angle 3. So a right angle is 90 degrees, so think of a corner of a square or a rectangle. The symbol for 90 degrees is finishing that small box in the corner, and this is angle 3. And remember, the number label goes on the inside of the angle near the vertex, so angle 3. And finally, number 12, a straight angle, angle CDE. Remember, a straight angle is an angle with the measure of 180 degrees. That is a straight line. So this D is the vertex of the angle, so that's going to be a point between C and E. So it makes C over here and E over here. So you can see angle CDE. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this naming angles worksheet. But before you go into the next video, remember to subscribe to my channel. All subscriptions are greatly appreciated. And it lets you know when I'm coming out with a new video. So go ahead and click that subscribe button.